Now let us look at this finite automata. This finite automata is actually I've taken a complicated example directly instead of taking simple examples, because I think this method is so simple that you don't actually I can directly jump on to the complicated methods. So here we need to make a regular expression for this given finite automata, and we are going to use the Arden's method to give regular expression. So let us see how to do it. Okay, we have four states here, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. First of all, you need to understand what are the states which are unreachable from the start state. If you want to convert it to a regular expression, remove all the states which are unreachable. Here there are no states which are unreachable, every state is reachable. Secondly, for every state you have to write an expression. Like for example, Q1, if this Q1, how can you reach to Q1? You can reach to the state Q1 if you get B from Q2, that means if you get B from Q2, or if you get A from Q3, if you get A from Q3, or you get epsilon, that means you are at the start state, without just by seeing epsilon you will be staying at the same state. So you can reach Q1 by seeing this, by seeing B at Q2 or A at Q3 or epsilon. If you are at Q2, how can you reach Q2? To reach Q2, you have to see an A from Q1. That means, if you have to see an A from Q1, otherwise there is no other method to reach to Q2. If you want to reach to Q3, then you can only reach to Q3 only if you see B from Q1. If you see B from Q1. In the same way, for Q4, you can only reach Q4 if you see an A on Q2, or you can see an B on Q3, or you can see an A at Q4 or B at Q4. Okay, so this is the only method. Here in this complete finite automata, there's only one state which is a final state, that is Q1. Q1 is the only final state. So here in all these expressions, if we can solve this expression by removing these Q2 and Q3 by the appropriate symbols, then we can get a regular expression, right? And we are going to extensively use the theorem, which is R is equal to P plus RQ. It can be written as PQ star, which is the Arden's method. Okay, now for example here we have Q2 and we have Q3. You can replace Q2 and Q3 by their exact values here exactly, because we have four expressions and we have to solve this expression. We have to remove all the present states. So the first expression can be written as Q1 is equal to Q2B, and the value of Q2 is Q1A. So Q1A dot B plus Q3 can be written as Q1B plus Q1B dot A plus epsilon. Okay, now this can be written as Q1 is equal to epsilon plus, take Q1 common, so it is Q1 dot AB plus BA. Now if you compare it with the Arden's theorem, so you can see this is R, this one is R, this is R, this is P, this is R, and this is Q. So this complete can be written as PQ star. So we can see Q1 can be written as epsilon dot Q star, that is AB plus BA whole star, which is again equivalent to only AB plus BA whole star. Therefore, I represented the complete diagram just by using this simple regular expression. Okay, let us take few more examples and let us try to solve those examples to get regular expressions for those finite automata. Okay.